Surry Hills, Sydney, and among other aspects here with this old children's court, you have the number 66. 66. Just always amazes me how they get the numbers and everything into order.
Just always amazes me how they get the numbers and everything into order.
Why? Mommy. Duck it.
I get ignorant fools coming onto my channel all the time. I often block them, to be honest. It's a waste of time. They're wanting scientific proof. Well, here is Science House in Sydney. And among other aspects, on the doorway there, you have those lights. There are two of them. And in part, they would surely denote the aspect of the light body of two participants around that doorway, I would suggest. Pillars, if you will. Now, among other aspects, you have the stones there that, in a way, depict the light formation around the human body. And within here, you have the Holy Grail with the foliage pouring out, the garlands pouring out of the central figure right there. And you can see the emanations further out of that, those kind of bursts out further from that within that auric field. Looking further up the building, we can see the round lotus in there you've got that blue circle, and then you've got the lotus right there, and then you have emanations from that also. And then you can see that further, right in the middle shot, you can see the further flower. So the further etheric emanations pouring out. On a building with that Isis type design, which you can see around the, which I think denotes in part one of the layers of the magic ritual edifice, and you have Science House right there. We'll take a bit of a closer look. This is a very historic part of town, and it's interesting to have the orbs perhaps emerging from those pillars right there. And there are ones further down the street. But once again, we'll have a closer look at Science House. Again, another look at the bursts coming out from that central kind of chakra ritual edifice right there. And then further down the building, we have the cartouche. And then within here, rather elaborate garland set up with a kind of portal in the center. Emanations out of the flowers. The flowers either side of Science House. The rope configuration there also that you will see around lodges, the magic ritual edifice, the torch of illumination there within the design, among other aspects, with the flower there, further portal. On this building. Just outside the doorway here on the lighting, you can see that things just keep going and going and going with that further burst from that light pillar right there. And you can see the further entity here holding the smaller figure with the light burst from the head also. So you see the entity holding the smaller figure in Egypt, among other places. So, really interesting. Now, inside you have the magic circle within the doorway. There's a security guard in there, so I'm just going to see if I can access and take some photos. There are further interdimensional entities in there also, sort of depicted, if you will. As we look at a couple of images, this one I took through the window and another one from inside that's not my photograph, but I went inside and the security guard was there and he wouldn't let me take photographs, so I put a call through to the Sydney Harbour Foreshore Authority. They wouldn't let me, the guy said I had to phone up the building manager, so I phoned up the building manager, and the building manager would not let me take photographs without going through some further steps via their website and all the rest of it, so I dropped that notion nonetheless. Within the foyer, there were the three lamps there within the fasheye. Now, the lamps, if you think about the lamps give off fumes, if you will, the smoke, if you will. And I would suggest that within further rituals, within the actual physical space, that this is actually utilized to a degree where the entities perhaps have the ability to actually accumulate some of that smoke, if you will. Within there was quite a reasonable amount of symbology, including angel type creatures and of course garlands and further aspects. Just noting that on the plaque on the exterior of the building where you have the Sulman Award for Architectural Merit, well, what entities do you see in there? You see an angel-type figure, and of course within the writings of Ledbetter, there is the talk of building angels, and the Masons would depict this, I would suggest, and hint towards this. And I know this is off the cards for the general public, but nonetheless, they put it there right in front of you. What else would you have on an architectural award? Just to note that we are looking at Science House, and there is a certain irony behind the whole thing. But beyond that, it reminds me also of the Faculty of Medicine at Sydney Uni, with the two kind of angel figures there holding the veil, among other aspects, unto which the veil would be protecting, I would suggest, the light body of the human, the further etheric kind of light structure of the human being. These buildings, these bastions of science, yet they hold this deeply occult symbolism that the average person's just going to have basically no idea about. Looking at the foundation stone here, the date would be the 24th of June in 1930. Now, that would be, for the Southern Hemisphere, the winter solstice time. This is St. Patrick's Catholic Church here in Sydney, Australia. Now, you have the classic three doorways here, and above each of these doorways, as a bit of a descriptor as to what is going on there, you have the priest right in the aura there with the fields around the priest. You'll also notice that they're also in a kind of a pillar in a way. Now, so there are three. So there are the two there that match with the doors, and then this, the central door here, and you would have St. Patrick up here. Within the aura. The three doorways also reflected in the three windows there also, I would suggest. The doorway of the of St. Patrick's Church features the light. Now, the light would perhaps in part denote the pillar of light that goes right through the center, and that would have reference to the Vishuddha chakra, the throat chakra, among other aspects. And you see the mage up there kind of aligning with that. Now, in St. John's Cathedral in Parramatta, you have those central pillars of light. They're also a bit more descriptive. In the doorway, you have the third eye depicted carefully in here with the auras around before you even enter St. Patrick's Cathedral, and this motif is around Sydney. Within St. Patrick's, you have the female one side, the male the other, with the mage in the centre.
You have St. Patrick here with the foliage emanating from the palm of the hand. And the same would apply with the crozier in a way also. You can see the garlands up here. Heart chakra, crown chakra. Aura and third eye and crown chakra. Lion's paws and foliage emanating from the pillar. Up here, first here you have the dog, the elemental, with the torch coming from the mouth, the etheric emanation coming from the mouth. Now, first here you have the dog, the elemental, with the etheric emanation coming from the mouth. Up here, you have, first of all, you have the classic mother and child, but here you have the further entity on the hand with the veil right there. The veil depicts an etheric field, I would suggest, and you see that iconography elsewhere. Just a further look around the church, the entities sort of within the ritual space in a way, participants in a way, and again up here, lion's paws, foliage. Again up here with the further entities around the ritual edifice right here. Now there's tons and tons of symbolism within here with all the foliage and the orb, the foliage and the orb within that portal way, that grail way right there, among many other aspects. And here you can see that it's all depicted in light. So the entities are within the light structures right here. And interestingly, you have little jewels in there also, kind of fire and water in this case, the elemental perhaps, but also the kind of light structure, if you will. And notice that they're kind of sitting mid-air amidst the pillars. There's that grail, an aspect to the human body, the further light aspect to the human body. The entities around here, all within this sort of temple of the church, this crown chakra like region.
Only those of you who are really on the ball will have noticed the fleur-de-lis, the flowers of light in the auric space around the figure, within the footage within St. Patrick's Church. Now, this is actually repeated on Science House that we have looked at prior, with the foliage and those bursts within what is really an auric space being depicted on that building. You can see those flower bursts or fleur-de-lis-like bursts within the auric space depicted around Indian entity Yakshi. A closer inspection of Yakshi will yield the flower at the forehead, the Ajna chakra, and again another flower at the upper abdominal region, but notably going down the midline there, down the kind of main chakra line, if you will, and the emanations of foliage out from the body and out from the legs, out from the midline. And you will have noticed that with that grail depiction and the emanations out from that midline within the window also of the science house. Now, of course, beyond this, there are further images of the flowers within the auric region. So this is repeated over and over and over for those with eyes to really see. In my prior video, I made comparison between what Rosicrucian, and I disagree with Rosicrucian Stephen Mailer at a, quite a deep level, because I really think that he should damn well know better. But he is trying to tell people that there are light bulbs depicted there, and it's not on. But anyway, so on his shirt, he has the boats depicted there, and just even looking at that, there are aspects to that, but you just got to know your stuff. Look at my prior video. There's one lot of knowledge for people within the occult orders, and there's one lot of knowledge for educated people out there who think they know their